Good afternoon to everyone. I am Divya Tadi, a student of third year Triple E in BVRIT Hyderabad, India. So today I am going to present a talk on real-time monitoring system using wireless sensor network for mine safety. So as we all know, in mines, basically the workers are prone to lots of toxic gases, as in when they are mining activities that go on, that is maybe blasting or something. At that point of time, there are many gases, that is some of them are very toxic, that come out, due to which the miners' health are in jeopardy. So basically, my real-time monitoring system tracks the amount of, the parameters that monitor the gases, that is the toxic gases, etc., and displays them onto the screen. So, the contents of the talk. The problem statement, problem analysis, problem solution, the technical solution, technical implementation, prototype, Zigbee configuration, final data output, prototype snippet, further development. Okay, what's the problem statement? So we have to prevent the unsafe incidents that are occurring in mines, basically. So we have to prevent the fire explosion and accidents. We have to prevent unsafe accidents that are causing health issues to the workers, thus protect mine workers from hazards, thereby also reduce losses of property, productivity and profits, protect destruction of natural resources and environment. The challenges. Okay, so we have to create a real-time monitoring system which monitors the safety parameters like the gases, the toxic gases, temperature and humidity. Okay, so the challenges that are being faced while doing this is collection of data, transmitting the data, acquiring the data from the underground mines, analysis of the data, generate relevant alerts. So the problem analysis is divided into two parts, that is, one is the fire accidents and one is the gases that are being produced. So the fire accidents have the source and impact. So the sources are gases released during explosions and gases released in coal beds. So the impacts of these are injuries or life loss and also loss of property and productivity. So the incidence of explosion and fire depend on the flammability of gases and is high in methane and carbon monoxide. So, and the generation of harmful gases, sources and impacts. So the blasting and explosion, gases released from coal beds, spontaneous combustion, accidental fires. So the impact of these sources are health, that is mainly on the health impact. So asthma, bronchitis, headache, fatigue, and sometimes causes death. So these two gases are considered for the prototype, that is the methane and the carbon monoxide as of now. So they're more harmful gases than these two. So the health impact depends on the exposure time and toxicity levels. We need a system to remotely monitor the gases and fire explosion in real time. So the problem solution is, we need a monitoring system to monitor the fire accident and harmful gases. And to monitor this, we need a temperature. We need to monitor the temperature, humidity, methane, and carbon monoxide. So to monitor these parameters, we need some sensors. And the sensors I have used is DTH11 sensor, MQ4 sensor, MQ7 sensor. So after monitoring, after getting the values from the sensor, we need to basically send the information to the computer so that someone can actually monitor the data, the parameters. And also, when the parameters exceed the threshold value, we need a buzzer to basically give up an alarm that this is exceeded the threshold value. So the technical solution is, we are going to have two units. One is the sensor unit and another is the monitoring unit. And in the sensor unit, we have the sensors first, that is methane, carbon monoxide, temperature and humidity. And these sensors will be connected to the microcontroller. And the microcontroller basically acquires sensors data, processes the data, controls the buzzer, LED and the Zigbee, transmits the data to the Zigbee. And this micro data from the microcontroller is being transmitted to the Zigbee. So actually, I've used the Zigbee technology because its range is really very high. And basically, Zigbee has this set data wherein it transfers 250 kilobits of data per second, so which is actually suitable for sensor technology. Whenever we use a sensor input or any input device, this Zigbee technology comes into very handy. So I have used two Zigbee. I have configured one Zigbee as the transmitter and another Zigbee as a receiver. So this Zigbee transmitter basically collects the data from the microcontroller and then transmits the data to the Zigbee receiver, that is in the monitoring unit. So the Zigbee receiver here collects the data from the Zigbee transmitter and further transmits the data to the Zigbee monitor. And near the Zigbee monitor, we have acquired the data from the Zigbee receiver and displays that data. So the technical implementation of the sensor unit and monitoring unit. This is basically a methane sensor, carbon monoxide sensor, temperature and humidity sensor. So these three sensors are connected to the Arduino Uno, which is the microcontroller. And in turn, an Arduino Uno is connected to a buzzer and an LED display. And the Arduino Uno has to be interfaced with the Zigbee, and for which we will be needing an interface board. So here we've used a Zigbee interface board. And yes, this is a Zigbee transmitter. And this is the Zigbee receiver. And this is the Zigbee receiver board, which will be connected to the monitor display. So I would like to tell clearly the flow. So basically, the sensors will be sensing the sensing the gases and all, from which the information will be passing on to the microcontroller. If the threshold values of the gases, etc., will be exceeding the limits, it will be sending signals to the buzzer. Then the buzzer will buzz. And simultaneously, these values will be displayed on the LCD. And later, okay, so this is the sensor unit and the monitoring unit. As you can see, this is the LCD, wherein the values of the temperature, carbon monoxide and all are displayed. This is the buzzer. And these are the sensors. This is a Zigbee transmitter, and this is the microcontroller. This is the sensor part, and this is the monitoring unit. And the monitoring unit consists of the interface board and the Zigbee module. Moving on to the next slide, how to configure Zigbee. So we have an open source software called XCTU software, wherein we can configure the Zigbee. So we have to configure the Zigbee, one as an coordinator, another as a router. So here we have to set the same PAN address for the Zigbee and the for the Zigbee transmitter and the Zigbee receiver, and we have to make some changes in the configuration such that one works as a transmitter and another works as a receiver, and set the remaining values to the default. So this is the final data output. So as you can see, this is the transmitter Zigbee. This is a transmitter Zigbee, and this is the receiver Zigbee. So I have got the temperature sensor, methane sensor, and the carbon monoxide sensor values onto the Zigbee receiver console. This is the final data output. So this is the prototype snippet. So it is hard to test the methane and carbon monoxide values in a home environment. Basically, I've set this up at home. So it is basically hard to test those. So in order to show the working prototype, what I have done is reduce the threshold values. I'll just show the video. Okay, as you can see, the temperature value is 31. The methane value is 192. So likewise, what I have done is I have reduced the value of the temperature in the code. So I'm dumping the code. It's compiling. Thank you. It's uploading the code to the microcontroller. And this is the buzzer. Sorry, it's too loud. So by reducing the threshold value, I have basically found a way to test this, test whether these sensors are working or not. So likewise, I have changed all the other parameters values. I have reduced the parameter threshold values and I've checked whether the sensors are working or not. Also working. In the same way, I have tested all the four sensors. Sorry, hold on. So this is the working prototype. So the further developments. Add more sensors for detecting other gases like carbon dioxide, oxygen, and hydrogen sulfide. Perform testing of sensors in real lab environment using fire, temperature, methane, carbon monoxide, etc. Design and develop the casing for the device. Program the monitoring unit to process the data acquired, perform analysis, and generate appropriate message, alerts, and warnings. Establish a two-way ZigBee communication and develop ZigBee network model and test this product on site. Thank you. Any questions?
Yeah.
Right. Yeah. I have a few.
Okay.
First of all, very interesting. Thank you. How much does it cost for the part?
Okay. Do I have to tell individually? So actually, I'm going to set up a network. This is basically only a device, right?
Yeah.
In the later time, I'm going to make it a network.
Okay.
So I cannot write. Okay, I'll just tell you the details of this.
Approximately
it's going to cost 1,000 rupees.
Okay.
Only the monitoring unit.
Okay.
And then the receiving unit, the bigger one that I showed this side,
yeah,
that's going to cost about 2,000.
Okay.
Overall, this whole thing might cost approximately to 3,000.
So that's about, what, $30?
Yeah.
Okay. The sensors, can they be used for monitoring pollution levels as well?
Yeah, pollution. So in underground mines, you want to test the pollution?
Well, in general, the
yeah,
air quality.
So there are other sensors which can be used to monitor pollution.
Right.
So I think it'll be better to use that.
Have you calibrated?
Yes, I have calibrated.
So
in later time, what I am planning to do is give the threshold value. So see, now I have given the threshold values as 30, as you saw in the video.
Yeah.
So later, I am planning to give this set of thing to the owners of the mines, wherein they can set, because the mining temperatures might differ, right?
Sure.
So I'm planning to make a small website kind of a thing, wherein they can actually put this threshold values. They can actually stipulate those values and they can give the threshold value so that it can if it exceeds that value, they can monitor the sensors.
But how do you know that the sensors are accurate and continue to be accurate?
Yeah, so the sensor values goes to the ZigBee every second.
Right.
So actually, right now, if I have the ZigBee, I can show you every second that is coming.
Okay.
The data it goes every second.
Right.
So I could have showed you that, but right now I'm not having the ZigBee module with me.
Okay.
So I just showed you this, right?
So So what one does is that one manually monitors
yeah.
it, and if you start seeing a swing.
Swing. Yeah.
Then perhaps the sensors are starting to be.
So maybe I'm actually planning to write a code for that also.
Okay.
To actually, if a person is sitting right in front of the monitor,
right.
in case that threshold value exceeds, I would write a code where it buzzes there also. So it'll
right.
be easy for him to notify to get notified if there's a swing in the gases sensor values.
Okay, and I suppose with that monitoring system, you would know when the Arduino dies as well, right?
So Arduino, basically, if it dies, we have to replace one.
Okay.
We have no other option.
Because I was considering using Arduinos for industrial applications
mm-hmm.
as well. But then one thing that came to mind was that there's no sort of uptime guarantees on the Arduino, right? There's no lifetime. So if I was going to use it to control our robots in a French factory, and then I realized if this thing dies on me. My friend's million baht investment suddenly goes poof.
Yeah, so noting this point, we have used the Zigbee technology wherein it's very easy to replace the end device.
Sure.
So it is very easy. So we just have to replace the Arduino, not the whole setup.
Right.
It is very easy this way. So that's the reason I chose the Zigbee technology in this case.
Okay.
Yeah.
Other thing, since you're doing this, there are plenty of fake Arduinos on the market.
Yeah.
And they look
exactly
the same.
Yeah.
I actually have a blog post about it.
Okay.
On Richard.net.
Yeah.
Check it out. It comes down to the the Arduino has a map of Italy printed on it.
Yeah.
The original one is in high res. The fake ones
yeah.
are not as good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So we have to be very keen while selecting the Arduino. That's all we can do.
Yeah.
We have to be vigilant while selecting one. Yeah.
Okay. Well, great job. Thank you.
Thank you. Any more questions? No. Yeah, please.
From what you see that you're using a transmitter receiver,
yeah.
do you have any plans for adding Zigbee repeaters as well?
Pardon?
Zigbee repeaters.
Zigbee?
Okay. Zigbee, there's the mesh
net. Yeah. Codes. Yeah.
So,
for
this presentation, is just
a
transmitter receiver.
Yeah. See.
Mesh.
Yeah, I'm gonna try meshing. I mean, use the mesh network in the later stages because this is only the prototype of the devices. So later, I'm gonna create more such devices and create a mesh network, so that information from miles can be from distant places can be. Basically, information can be retrieved from distant places also. Thank you. Yeah.
For the gas sensors,
yeah.
is actually no air moving, or is it just like this? Because I would feel like if there's a gas leak somewhere here,
mm-hmm.
some pressure is here, by the time the gas doesn't just expand so quickly, so do you have some sort of, let's say, to keep a particle in water, you need some sort of flow, so the gas, just use them like this?
I didn't get you. We can actually increase the sensitivity. So in case we need to catch a very small amount of gas also, we need to change the sensitivity values in the code, so that even if there's a slight change, we can actually catch the gas values. Yeah. Any more questions? Yeah.
Okay,
thank you.
Thank you.